Fins are a type of extended surface that can enhance heat transfer between a solid and its adjoining fluid. Conductive heat transfer occurs within the solid, and then you have convective and conductive heat transfer from the extended surface. In fins, we generally assume that radiation is negligible. So let's start with a differential element from a fin. And we're going to do an energy balance around this. Here we have our dx. We have coming in our q sub x. And coming out from the back, we have our q at x plus dx. In addition, we have coming from here convective heat transfer that we'll call dq convective. So our energy balance is going to simplify to that in equals out. So looking at this element, we find coming in, we have q of x. Coming out, we have our q at x plus dx. Plus our dq convective. According to Fourier's law, q of x is equal to minus k times the cross-sectional area, which it's going through, dt dx. We assume in using Fourier's law this way that k is constant. Now we look at x plus dx, our q at x plus dx is equal to our q at x plus dqx dx times our differential x. So we'll call this equation one, call this equation two, and this equation three. Now let's substitute equation two into our equation three. We'll call this equation four. Now we're going to find our convective heat transfer. So using Newton's law of cooling, this is going to equal H, the convective heat transfer coefficient, which we're going to assume is constant over the surface of the fin. dA sub s, where this is the surface area, T minus T infinity. And now let's put all of these expressions back into our energy balance. And if you notice that Q of x cancels out, we can rewrite this as d dx a sub c dt dx times dx, and I divide it through by our k. So this is minus h divided by k d a sub s t minus t infinity, and this is going to equal zero. So we use the chain rule and divide through by both a sub c and dx, and we're left with d squared t dx squared plus 1 over a sub c dac dx, all multiplied by dt dx, minus 1 over a sub c. And now here's our h over k dAs dx multiplied by t minus t infinity. And this entire expression equals zero. We're going to look at a fin. We're going to say that it has a uniform cross-sectional area and it has a base that has a constant temperature, T sub B, and it extends into a fluid that has a temperature of T infinity that's also constant. Our surface area can be written as the perimeter of our element times x. So if we find dAs dx, this is going to equal P. In addition, we said that our cross-sectional area was constant, so our derivative of that with respect to x is going to equal 0. So now we're left with d squared t dx squared minus h times p, which is that perimeter, divided by that thermal conductivity, times the cross-sectional area, all multiplied by t minus t infinity equals 0. Now we're going to define an excess temperature, and this is going to be theta, and that's defined as the difference between a temperature at some x minus t infinity. In addition, we're going to define an m squared as this h times p divided by k times our cross-sectional area. And because our t infinity is constant, our d theta dt is equal to our dt of x dx. So what we're left with is d squared theta dx squared minus m squared times theta equals 0. This is a linear homogeneous second order differential equation with constant coefficients, and the general solution has the form that theta of x is equal to c1 e to the mx plus c2 e to the minus mx. So now we're going to use the boundary conditions. We're going to say at x equals 0, our theta is going to equal theta sub b, which is going to be this constant temperature of the base minus t infinity. Then at x equals L, where L is the tip of the fin, we can have four different cases. So one of them is that we have at the tip convective heat transfer. Another condition is that the tip is adiabatic. A third case is that we have some prescribed constant temperature, T sub L. And finally, we have what's known as an infinite or a very long fin. So using one of these four boundary conditions, we get a different solution, and the temperature distribution as well as the heat transfer rate of the fin can be found in appropriate tables.